Good early morning. I'm Steve Benoon. You're watching Israeli News Live. It's October the 13th, and we are want to take a few moments here to look at this clip from CNN where President Biden speaks about the situation in Ukraine, specifically Putin, his state of being there. But he also talks in this video here, you know, where the title says Biden sends a careful but chilling nuclear message to Putin in a CNN interview. And I want to play this because I am privy to the information about on October the 12th. Basically, it was just yesterday, but technically today for me because I'm kind of still up. Hadn't gone to bed yet there, but I was given the information how that he came in this morning to the White House very angry this morning. And I was told that the night before he was in a meeting with Hillary Clinton. And of course, Hillary Clinton is the right-hand man, so to speak, or woman in this case, to George Soros, who has been grooming the youth of Ukraine for quite some time now. And the message that I was given is that President Biden came into the White House angry over the situation that is going on in Ukraine, that is continuing, and that they have not stopped Putin as of yet. But he said that he would use nuclear war, if that's what it takes, to bring Putin to a stop on overtaking this country here, or at least, as we should say, not that Putin is trying to overtake Ukraine, but the real truth of the matter is to create a buffer zone between himself and the West, especially since the United States has already said that they would help Ukraine to get nuclear weapons and put those in right there on the border of Russia. Putin would never allow such a thing in the first place. But at any rate, not only that, I was told that President Biden made it very clear that he is in charge. He is the president of the United States, and he will call the shots on what's going to go on there in Ukraine. Now, with that being stated there, I want you to listen to this clip here on the interview that he did on CNN here, where they title it, Biden sends a careful but chilling nuclear message to Putin in a CNN interview, because I've just told you a little bit more in depth of what President Biden is thinking. And oddly enough, as it was said to me, what's really odd is that Biden's son, Hunter Biden, is really starting to get the heat brought up on him by the Justice Department. But it says it's not slowing President Biden down from fully grabbing a hold of the reins here of the war going on in Ukraine, and determined that he will direct every step of that. And as I said, I was told that he said that he would use nuclear war if that's what it takes to win this war against Russia. Listen in. Give it just a second.
What is the red line for the United States and NATO, and have you directed the Pentagon and other agencies to game out what a response would be if he did use a tactical nuclear weapon, or if he bombed the Zaporizhia nuclear power plant in Ukraine, or anything along those lines?
There's been discussions of that, but I'm not going to get into that. It would be irresponsible of me to talk about what we would or wouldn't do.
Have you asked the Pentagon to game it out, though? I mean, just in case?
The Pentagon didn't have to be asked.
So French President Macron told me that he...
That's what gets me right there. The Pentagon didn't have to be asked. How would the Pentagon game it out? I can tell you already, the Pentagon has been running war game scenarios quite frequently here in the last few weeks. And in all scenarios, the United States does come out on top using the AI system that they're using right now. Of course, I was also told, though, that they're not taking into consideration World War II, that Adolf Hitler was aided by a cabinet that was full of Jewish elite. I want to put it that way, the word elite there, because it's nothing against the Jewish people, but sadly, what has happened to the Jewish people and my own extended family in the same sense there that was killed in the Holocaust, by none other than people that were in power, elite Jews, like George Soros, who directed such horrible campaigns against their own. And I was told that that part of the equation is being left out. When we say that part of the equation is being left out here, whether or not the United States would come on top or not in this war, it's because Israel is going to be the head of the New World Order. And I'm going to be doing a special teaching on that, especially from the book of Ezekiel, very soon here. I'm working on that. Hopefully, I'll be able to bring that out this weekend on Dunoon Institute of Biblical Research. But in this case right here, President Biden is saying that the Pentagon didn't have any need to do anything, right? That was kind of interesting. Let's play that back just a little bit there. Let's see if we can, let's back it up and see if we can catch that clip again there.
Have you asked the Pentagon to game it out, though? I mean, just in case?
The Pentagon didn't have to be asked.
So, French President...
Pentagon didn't have to be asked. Why? Because, like I said, President Biden said this morning when he was very angry over the situation in Ukraine that he was in control, he's in charge, and he will be calling the shots. He didn't care what anybody else had to say. You know, and of course, as I've been told, Biden is trying to really stand tough. He's trying to appear that he's really tough and everything, you know, because he's caught so much ridicule to begin with because of the accusations of dementia, Alzheimer's, and things of that nature there. He certainly wants to make sure he's in control. Like I said, though, the night before I was told that he was in a meeting with Hillary Clinton, and she seems to be egging him on, quote unquote, was a statement that was made to me on this issue there. So take that for what it's worth there, and let's just move on here. The other thing, too, President Putin landed in Kazakhstan there. He's set there to attend the summit of the Conference of the Interaction of the Confidence Building Measures in Asia. And there was quite a number of people there in that delegation. I just want to share this with you right here. Of course, the President of Kazakhstan right there in the very center, President Putin to the right, and President Erdogan actually to his left shoulder of the President of Kazakhstan. Now, this brings up another interesting issue. In light of this meeting that was going on, I actually asked about would Turkey, who is a NATO member, would they be willing to forfeit? Would they be willing? Or excuse me. Would President Erdogan of Turkey actually abandon NATO and side with Russia in the event of a war, an all-out war, I should say, over Ukraine? And the answer was, in Washington, they believe that Turkey will abandon NATO if it comes down to it, that Turkey would side with China and Russia. And of course, this is the other big issue that the United States is facing, and that is the war games that are being shown right now, the United States versus Russia over Ukraine with NATO and their allies. The United States would come out on top, even economically. They would withstand it. They would weather it much better than any of the other nations that could be involved. However, where it gives a very grim picture is in the event we end up in a war with China as well. And that being stated, because China's Navy has been moving into position, it is believed that China is really preparing very aggressively to take down Taiwan. And I've already been told that the United States will show some face to try to protect Taiwan, but at the end of the day, they're not willing to go all the way if that's what it takes in order to keep Taiwan safe, because of the situation in Ukraine seems to be what's kind of pushing that there. Also here, I wanted to share this with you here. Glenn Beck here, when he used to do, what was it, the Blaze, I believe it, Glenn did. I haven't looked at Glenn in quite some time, except just the other day. And he's talking about Russia's submarine, their top secret submarine, disappearing from its post there. Let's listen in to Glenn.
Oh, man, you're just not going to believe this. But one of Russia's nuclear-powered submarines has reportedly vanished from its Arctic harbor. And NATO says it's concerned it could be gearing up to test its advanced weapons systems. Advanced systems, in fact, the system is called, but it is known as the Armageddon weapon.
The Poseidon.
I love that. So what is it? Well, the submarine is top shelf, brand new, and it has the Poseidon torpedo, which is a nuclear torpedo.
All right, now I want to just kind of share something with you here, because one of the things that came up as we were in this discussion earlier today is how will Putin respond to President Biden's threat of using nuclear war? And most people would assume that Putin would actually go full-scale nuclear war as well. But you have to remember, as strange as this may seem, and I know a lot of people just do not want to believe in fallen angels or ETs or whatever you want to call them, but Putin, from what those around the Joint Chiefs of Staff, I'll say it like that there, they believe that Putin would not go to nuclear war, that if Putin were to find out that Biden has made such a threat as he did this morning, that instead Putin would allow those nuclear plants to be struck, destroyed, and cause a fallout like never before in order to create a no man's land there in Ukraine, and create that buffer zone that they're trying to achieve in the first place. Of course, Russia is trying to achieve it not because of a nuclear fallout, but rather they have tried to surgically go in. They've tried to protect the Donbas, Luhansk regions, or the Donbas region, Donetsk region, I should say, which is actually Donbas covers the entire area there. They're trying to create that buffer zone in order to keep from having nuclear weapons put on their border. At the same time, too, another discussion that came up today, and that was Belarus. There's still that very real threat that war with Belarus is coming, and that NATO is going to strike Belarus from Poland. And I'm sure if they're going to strike Belarus from Poland, they're going to hit it from Lithuania, Estonia as well. Of course, Russia has there in Kaliningrad, that little tiny area right there, not a very big place there. I'm sure that would end up falling into NATO's hands in the beginning. And of course, Moscow, as you can see, not very far from Belarus. So if NATO strikes Belarus, Russia, as an ally of Belarus, will end up having to come to the aid of Belarus. And to me, that will just create an all-out war. That could be one of the reasons why, too, as Glenn Beck talks about that nuclear submarine departing its base there, could be one of the reasons why the sub has departed from its base there, getting out to sea, getting prepared. Of course, they say disappear. The United States knows where every submarine is, using some of the technology that was created by Tesla to begin with. And so therefore, they know where those submarines are. It's not just hidden, as some people would think. I'm Steve Bannon. Thank you for listening. Stay tuned this weekend. We'll be talking about the how this is going to play out biblically, because I certainly see some things when it comes to Ezekiel, the temple that Ezekiel writes about there. And I think it's going to shock you to know some of the truth of what that really speaks about. Stephen Bannon with Israeli News Live. Thank you for listening. Don't forget, subscribe here. And as well, if you've been a longtime subscriber, make sure you're still subscribed, because YouTube's very bad about taking people down. And also iConnectFX.com. Definitely get on that platform, because if anything ever happens to us here, that's where you're going to find us at. That's where we're not censored at. I'm Stephen Bannon. Have a great evening.